Hello, good morning, matricians. Greeting from Hong Kong, Eric, and also greeting from Beijing from our CEO, Owen. Today is the 28th of October. As most of you know, we have the monthly drill, that is the monthly AMA. We're shooting it now. So today we have 9 questions that we selected from a pool of around 40 questions. And I would like to start with the first question coming from Satosha Manato. The question is like this: what will be the biggest goal or targets of the Matrix for 2023, Owen?
As you know, we are still discussing about our new roadmap. We haven't had the results yet. But I'm sure that I think we will have some great plan in the next year about the Web3 industry and the Metaverse. I think we will do some very good project on Matrix in next year. Yeah.
Thanks, Owen. Satosha. So it may sound relatively quiet than previous month that we have many publications. And this month, or these 2 months, we have been spending a lot of efforts coming up with the new roadmap. And when Owen mentioned about some good projects, it actually means it's a very exciting projects. But we don't have a solid plan yet. But I can assure you the idea is kind of groundbreaking, and I'm sure most of you will love it when we have the details to be released. And so far, we have been spending a lot of efforts on the feasibility, etc. So just stay tuned. And again, it is quite exciting, not just a good projects. Often. And then we move on to the second question coming from No Fear. For computing power leads, when will be used? If mass value goes up, will the price of purchasing computing power goes up? How do you intend to achieve the balance? Could companies be forced to buy computing power at a high price? No fear. Yeah. So no fear, you do have some fear. Okay, and over to you, Owen.
Let me explain this. At first, our price is based on the fiat currency. The price will be calculated based on the offer and the demand relationship. If the offer is goes higher and the demand goes lower, the price will go lower. This is the first part. And the second part, we have put an oracle on our main chain, and it will calculate the price for man at the time when the price is changes. So if the man's price value goes up, and the fiat currency is price is stable, and you need to pay less money to buy your services. So I think you don't need to worry about this.
Okay, so that has been sort of at the beginning. Okay, when you talk about the to buy via currency, there is another question come from Amin Duffer. The question is, in the future, can we be able to purchase men with fiat currencies?
If you can treat this with your friend or something, someone you know, you face to face trading, you can use the fiat currency. But till now, we don't be listed any exchanges with supposedly that you can buy the currency with the fiat. So I think maybe in the future, if we are listed on some exchanges which support the fiat currency, I think you can do that.
Okay, so that depends on the whether there's such on-ramp services provided by the exchanges. Okay. And then as far as I know, there are some crypto wallets that offering such services, for example, crypto.com, or there are many of such. So you can get the on-ramp service from elsewhere, and then you can get the crypto, and then using the crypto, then you can exchange for the man. So that is kind of a indirect way, but it's also effective way as well. Yeah. So the second question goes to Postcode, and Postcode, thanks for testing out the Android wallet for us. And I know you have a problem with the transferring from the Android wallet to web wallet. So I have sent you the pack, and please install it, and then you can get your problem fixed. And likewise for other magicians encountering the same situation. Yeah. So Postcode, your question is about regarding the new partnership with RootCloud. The RootCloud does what Matrix Manito is supposed to do. Does RootCloud intend to adopt Matrix Manito solution?
That's a good question. The RootCloud is very similar as the Manito system. But in fact, we have different advantage in our system, such as the RootCloud had been a better cloud computer for the industry before. But we have some advantage in the image recognition algorithm. So in our corporations, we will offer our advantaged solutions for them, not all of the our solutions. And that's how we cooperate. They will use our better algorithms than them in their system. That's how the corporations run.
I think this is a very good question coming from Postcode, and I think some other magicians also are interested to know what's the details about the partnership, I mean, with the RootCloud and also the other two partnerships that we just newly formed with. When your time allows, Owen, could you spend some time and then give me some more details, and then we can have an announcement about its partnerships, and then the magician will be able to appreciate the importance or what kinds of advantage that we can leverage with each other with these partnerships. Is that doable, Owen?
Okay,
thanks. And then move on. Coming from Giuseppe's work. How will Matrix AI comply with legal regulations that are coming to the crypto markets in the near future?
I think we won't do something specially, because we are always doing our job according the laws about the cryptocurrency. So if the law about the current cryptocurrency has changed, and think we will change our job to make us legal.
Actually, we have been doing the compliance job very well since day one. And a good thing to share is the Hong Kong. I think just within these 2 weeks, the government is very active in forums and different situations that the government officials wants to promote Hong Kong as the hub for the crypto stuff. So this is a very important thing for us, and we will see that is a positive sign for the crypto and for Matrix as well. And just starting from next Monday or something, that there will be a series of fintech related global conference happening in Hong Kong, and there is a global online section plus the in-person section. So if you are interested, you can Google it, and then you can join the online conference as well, which is about the fintech thing. Yeah. And move on. the name is HaHa001. So that lights us our day, HaHa001. Okay. So your question is, how does Matrix support 3D images, animations, and speech in the Metaverse? Owen?
In fact, all the functions you mentioned, they need lots of the computing power supported. Yeah, so that's how Meta, you can use Meta to support the 3D images, animations, and the speech in Metaverse.
Yeah. Yeah. Hi, HaHa001. So just for your information, you can refer to one of our article series, which is about the Matrix X, the brain for Metaverse. So you can get some more details, ideas from there. And Bosgood, my appreciation to you because you do read our announcement and you do your own research work, trying to check what is RootCloud about and then raise questions from there. So that's a very good thing, and it's a mature behavior. And I hope the whole crypto community can follow the same pattern, do the own research, and then follow the announcement or the updates of the project of all. Yep. And come from Doug Funley, are there any plans to build a DEX on Matrix?
Until now, not yet. We haven't any plan to build a DEX on Matrix because there are some existing solutions such as the Uniswap and maybe the Pancake on the Binance Smart Chain, and all of them are very good. So I don't think we need to build another DEX right now. Yeah, but maybe in the future, if we find some new business model which can change the DEX ecosystem, maybe we will do that. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. To supplement to what Owen just said, that funny. I think this depends on the positioning of the project. So right now, you know, we are coming up with the roadmap for the Matrix 3.0, and there is a big transformation. Okay, so that is what I can say. And a DEX is too little for us, so to speak, when you compare with the vision of our upcoming Matrix 3.0. So it's not what we cannot do is what our vision will be, and I'm sure the vision will be much bigger than the DEX. So it comes the eighth question from Crypto Tony. Let us know what types of partners Matrix AI is searching for regarding expansion of brand and better market influence.
Right now, the partners we are searching for is if more about our mentor, Manas and Manito. Yeah, we need all kinds of partners and customers to use our services, which can add the demand for the main coin. That's what kinds of the partners we are searching for right now. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks. If Crypto Tony, you have any good connections in this regards, then do suggest to us or write to me directly. Yeah. Last question from Bosscut again. Yeah. Industry 4.0 platforms are becoming popular and they are taking their market share. They may not use blockchain, but centralized computing platform meeting their requirements. Don't you think by delaying the Matrix computing platform and Melito release, you will lose the Matrix market share?
Yeah, that's a interesting question. I want to say, in fact, the market is not as same as the report you have seen in the internet or any other ways. Because until now, at first, this is a very huge market. There has lots of the room we can feel them. Yeah. And till now, we can't use the common solutions to solve all kinds of the problems the companies meet, because when we are running our Manito platform, the different companies has their own personal demands on their business. So a common solution platform can't meet the market requirement right now. So till now, we still has to communicate with the older customers what they need, and we need to do a personal solution for them right now. So I think this is a very, very, very early beginning for this market. So I think we have enough time to run our business, and there's still enough room for our business to fill in. Yeah.
Yeah. So Bosquez, to sum up, it's a very huge market and it's still early. So we still have a lot of time, and we do can fill up the gap that there is between the centralized solutions and decentralized solutions. Right. Okay. So that's the live questions that we selected for this AMA. And before end this conversation with Owen, I just like to share, just yesterday, we Owen and I had another discussion. I mean, after many rounds of discussion about it, Matrix 3.0, we discussed about the third or fourth levels of what the roadmap will be about, and then also some marketing ideas. So we are quite excited about it, and just that it is not yet at the right timing that we release details. And speaking of that, we are still coming up with white paper, a document to gather all these concepts into one common framework with a timeline, etc. So when we have all this ready, we are certainly and be very proud to share with you, and I'm sure you will have a wow effect when you read the roadmap or the vision that we are creating for Matrix 3.0. Yeah. So just stay tuned for that. Yeah. Often, how's the weather in Beijing? Does it start to slow, or what was the best month for Beijing?
A little cold right now. I need to take a heavy coat when I go outside. Yeah.
Okay. Start to slow or not yet? Snow?
Not yet.
Any slow? Not yet. Okay.
Not yet.
So it's still autumn time?
In the countryside, yeah, maybe some place has been snowing. Yeah.
Okay. So I think it's the best season to go to see some trees. I think that the color of the leaves are red. Is that?
Yeah, it's right now.
It's right now. So it's the best season.
The best season in Beijing. Yeah.
Yeah, it's not hot and it's not freezing. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Good. Yeah, good. So send us regards to Ken and also Professor Steve Deng for the whole community. Okay.
Okay.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Owen, for your time, and thanks, Matrician, for submitting these questions and watching this AMA videos. Until next time, stay tuned and stay safe. Bye.
Bye-bye.